Tonight, we're hearing more reaction after the Trump administration decided to end some government funding fetal tissue research. Pro-life groups say the experiments rely on aborted babies and have not provided any medical breakthroughs. White House correspondent Mark Irons reports. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Wyatt. Critics of this Trump administration decision say fetal tissue research is vital to create vaccines and has led to life-saving treatment. But besides the ethical concerns, pro-life groups and some healthcare professionals will tell you there's no science to back up those claims.
As an example of bipartisan cooperation.
A senior Trump administration official says the decision to stop government scientists from using fetal tissue for research was the president's own call. Pro-life groups applaud the plan, arguing taxpayers shouldn't be funding research that uses aborted baby body parts. The U.S. Conference of Catholic Bishops released a statement saying, "Scavenging and commodifying the body parts of abortion victims for use in research gravely disrespects the bodies of these innocent human beings. Their remains deserve the same respect as that of any other person." Still, critics have slammed the Trump administration's decision. A senior policy manager with the Guttmacher Institute claims the plan to stop fetal tissue research poses a direct threat to crucial research to find treatments for HIV and other health threats. But Dr. David Prentice, research director for the pro-life Charlotte Lozier Institute, says that's simply false.
The proponents of using aborted fetal tissue are either, when they make those statements, ignorant of the science and the history, or willfully deceptive.
Prentice says the government should not rely on the destruction of human life for research. He says it's bad science, and there are better methods that have provided real results.
In December, the director of the National Institutes of Health, Dr. Francis Collins, said there is strong evidence that scientific benefits come from fetal tissue research, and he said it would continue to be the mainstay for certain types of research. Now, that caused many pro-lifers to call for Dr. Collins' resignation. They are now hopeful he will carry out this new directive from the president. Wyatt?
White House correspondent Mark Irons reporting. Thanks, Mark.